Help us have coronavirus to stop. Help all of the people who are sick with coronavirus be well again. Please help church. Please help church go good this week. Please help all the people who are working very hard to keep their jobs. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. Hosanna! Hosanna!
Jesus is coming.
Hosanna! Hosanna!
Oh, my head hurts. Father, forgive me.
Everybody, wasn't that an awesome prayer? And then we had the Canning family do an introduction to our whole service today. It's Palm Sunday. I've got my Easter egg. I'll show you this a little later. And today we're going to talk about how Jesus came to show his love. I don't know about you, but Easter is not just about eggs and bunnies. It's about God's love. And that's what we're going to talk about. Hey, that reminds me of a song. Jesus is my best friend. So maybe you guys and girls can all stand up at home and get ready to clap your hands. And can you sing as loud as you can? Let's get ready. Here we go.
Jesus is my best friend, my best friend, my best friend. Jesus is my best friend. He's always there for me.
So we're going to do a word scramble, and these words have a really important meaning for Easter, and especially today it is
Palm Sunday.
Palm Sunday. All right, this is really cool. So can you unscramble this word? Can anybody do it?
Yeah.
All right, what do you think it is?
Hosanna.
Yes, it's Hosanna. And the definition for Hosanna is the Lord saves, and it's found in Matthew 21:19. And I'd love for you guys to open your Bibles and to read those verses. So yes, Hosanna, hooray, the Lord
saves.
The next one is, can you unscramble this one? Oh,
I know it.
You know it?
Oh,
so it. What do you guys think it is?
Right.
Praise, yes, definition. It's to make much of God. So when we lift our hands and when we praise God, we are making much of God. So isn't that cool? How many of you guys love to lift your hands and praise God? So that's what it's all about. Okay, the next one. Can you unscramble this one?
Yeah.
Can you guys and girls at home unscramble it? Do you guys all have it? What is it?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And the definition is a shout of joy or praise or gratitude. So when we say hallelujah, when we're singing that song like we did at the very beginning, or singing Hosanna or hallelujah, we're shouting joy and praise and gratitude. And in Revelation 19 and 1, it tells us a really cool verse all about that. Can you unscramble this one? Drum roll, can we do Do you guys have it?
Kind of.
What do you think this one is? Does anybody have it?
No.
Oh, I bet at home you guys have it. Do I make this one
too hard? You guys are probably smarter than me.
Okay, here we go. It's awesome. And this word is an overwhelming feeling of reverence or admiration and even fear, a healthy fear of God. And in Psalm 66, verse 5, it tells us all about that. Celebrating the King of Kings, we can shout, Hosanna! Awesome!
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah. And what was the other one?
Praise.
Amazing! So God is all of those things. So remember today, Palm Sunday, to celebrate the King of Kings.
Look at me. Whoa, look at you. Reese, we're both cartoon characters.
Yeah, we are. This is how we're going to tell the story. Our story today is about Jesus and how he shows us his love for us.
L is for the way you look at me. O is for the only one I see.
Whoa there, greatest showman. Can we get back to the story?
Yeah.
Jesus showed us his love by the way he treated the people who were around him, and also by the miracles he did while he was here on earth.
Let's just say, Jesus was a pretty awesome guy.
Yeah, he was. Everything Jesus did got the people talking. They wondered if Jesus was the king God had promised to send to save them from the wrong things they had done.
So, was Jesus like Superman and just didn't realize he had special powers that God would use to save the world?
No. Jesus knew exactly why God had sent him to earth. He came to take the punishment for the wrong things we do and to give us life that would never end.
That's more powerful than anything Superman's got going on.
And the time had come for Jesus to do all that God had planned. He was on his way to the city of Jerusalem. And when Jesus got there, he rode in...
on a motorcycle! Oh, and that motorcycle had sidecars for his disciples, and the sidecars had sidecars!
Jesus rode in on a donkey. The people knew he had to be the king God had promised to send. So they waved palm branches and shouted, Hosanna!
Which means, save us.
A few nights later, Jesus and the disciples were eating a special meal together. Jesus knew this would be the last supper they would share before he went back to heaven.
His very last supper? I bet they ate something really fancy, like chicken nuggets with every type of dipping sauce.
Actually, Jesus kept it pretty simple. He thanked God for the bread, broke it up, and gave some to each of his disciples. Then, Jesus thanked God for the cup, and everyone ate and drank.
Wait, Jesus? The one who came to save everyone? Served his friends?
Sure did. That's another way he showed love. And get this, after dinner, he also washed everyone's feet.
That's kinda odd, isn't it?
Well, I guess the disciples weren't expecting it. That's usually a servant's dirty job.
That would be like Iron Man coming to wash my smelly socks. He's way too cool for that. I should be washing his socks.
Jesus explained to them how washing their feet was a way he could show them love.
That's some extravagant love.
Later that night, they all walked over to the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus spent some time praying by himself. As the night went on, things got really serious.
Oh man, is this when...
Yep.
And...
Exactly. How about you tell them this next part?
Once Jesus was done praying, he was arrested by a group of guys that didn't like him. Like, at all.
These people didn't like that Jesus claimed to be God's son. And they definitely didn't think he should be king. They made a plan to have Jesus put to death.
Wait a second. Did Jesus do anything wrong?
Nothing.
This is not right!
I understand how you feel, but the people insisted on taking Jesus before Pilate.
Who put this guy in charge?
Even though he agreed Jesus had not done anything wrong, he sentenced Jesus to death on a cross.
Wait, what? Couldn't God save people from their sins some other way?
No, remember, God had a plan. He knew that we would do wrong things.
Oh yeah, like when I lie about brushing my teeth after Oreos.
Yeah, sure, they're clean.
Because God hates sin, but loves us, he planned for Jesus to take all the punishment for the sins of all the people in the world.
Well, that's like so many people. Hundreds, thousands, millions!
That's why his death on the cross was so painful. It was definitely the biggest way that Jesus showed us love. He willingly gave up his life so that we could be forgiven by God.
It's the whole reason we have so much fun getting ready to celebrate Easter.
Aw, man! Next week can't get here fast enough.
All right. Well, hello, everybody. I want you guys to welcome my friends here today. Can you guys say hi?
Hi.
Oh, yeah, I can say hi. Hey, how's everyone doing? And Azzy, would you like to say hi, too?
Mm-hmm.
Well, go ahead and say hi. Are you ready? Mm-mm. Oh, come on. Can you just say hi to everybody? Come on, Azzy. Just say hello already.
All right. Hi, everyone. So good to see all of you guys here. It is
Palm Sunday. I'm so excited. You know what that means? Next week, it is
a new dress and Easter eggs.
Oh, wait a minute. Do you guys think that that's what Easter is really all about? Yep, it sure is. It's about new clothes and eggs and chocolate. I can't wait. Well, do you guys actually know what Easter is really about?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so Azzy, what is it really about?
Just like Jacob said, Easter is all about new clothes and eggs and chocolate.
No, actually, it's not. No, it's not. Easter is actually all about Jesus. How cool is that? Oh, wow. Jacob, what are you doing?
I'm just winking at that cute girl through the screen. Isn't she cute?
Oh, Jacob, you are so silly.
Well, hey, guys, you know what? Easter is all about Jesus. It's all about J-E-S-U-S. That's right.
You mean it's really not about Easter eggs and new clothes?
No. It's about when Jesus, God's only son, arose from the grave.
Wait a minute. He actually died?
Mm-hmm. I knew that.
Yes, he actually died. He died because he loved us so much.
Oh, yeah.
He died for all the bad stuff I did. Man, that sure is a lot.
It is a lot. But you know what? Jesus loves you no matter what. Isn't that so cool?
Mm-hmm. It sure is.
And how about if you sing that song, Jake, and to everybody, Jesus Loves the Little Children. Can you do that?
Yeah, I sure can.
Okay, go ahead.
Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world, red and yellow, black and green. Those are the cutest girls I've seen.
Wait a minute, Jake, and that is not how the song goes.
No, it sure isn't.
Why did you say green?
Because Azzy and I are wearing green, and I couldn't think of the right color.
Well, do you know what? Maybe Azzy can help you out. It's red and yellow, black and white.
Uh-huh. And you know what? How it really goes? We are precious in God's sight.
That's right. You are so precious. So guys and girls, remember that Easter is all about
J-E-S-U-S.
Uh-huh. It's all about Jesus.
I can't wait for Easter. I can't wait to kiss all the girls.
No. Remember, Jacob, you're not coming to church to kiss the girls or anything like that. You're coming to church on Easter Sunday to celebrate
Jesus, because he loves us so much.
That's right. Can you say bye to everyone?
See you later, dudes and dudettes. You guys are
awesome.
Thank you.
right, are you guys ready for an exciting Palm Sunday today? This is 1 week before Easter, when most of us will probably do an Easter egg hunt. How exciting is that? But I want to give you some background of what happened before Palm Sunday. It is so cool because this is a story that just happened about Lazarus. How many of you guys at home remember Lazarus? And just before all of this took place, Jesus raises Lazarus from the dead. He was wrapped in grave clothes and he was just put in the grave to die. But then Jesus calls Lazarus out of the grave. Can you imagine? He's been dead for a while and Jesus says, Lazarus, and he comes out and Lazarus is alive. And the people are getting ready to celebrate and do incredible things. So I'm going to use this egg to help us. So I'm going to open it up and see what's inside. Whoa, there's more eggs. And, well, I couldn't find a donkey anywhere, but I found a horse that represents a donkey. And Jesus told two of his disciples to go and find a donkey that was tied up and to bring it back to him. So that's what they did. Of course, they decided that they would obey Jesus and they would go and do that. So off the disciples went to find the donkey. And let's see what's in the blue egg. Are you ready? Let's open it up. What do you think might be in here? Does anybody know? Well, there is a coat. And this represents the coats. People took off their coats and their cloaks and they put them over the donkey so it would be a soft seat for Jesus. And not only that, people were taking off of their coats and they were laying them on the ground for Jesus to walk over because they were honoring him. He was the King of Kings. He just did a miracle. Lazarus was raised from the dead. Maybe at home you can take off your coats or your sweaters and you can lay them down and pretend that you're making a path for Jesus as well. Well, let's see what's in this silver one. Are you ready? So I'm going to open it up and it is a palm branch, just like you've seen some people using at home today when we did the Ho Ho Hosanna song. Well, the people got branches and they began to lay the branches down on the path for Jesus as well. And not only that, they were waving the branches and they were shouting, Hallelujah! Hosanna to the King! They were celebrating that Jesus was coming into Jerusalem. So here we go. So they laid the palm branches and the coats on the ground for Jesus to ride on. Well, let's see what's in the gold one. So I open the gold one and, oh, something interesting in this one. It is red. This reminds me of the Last Supper that Jesus was going to have with his disciples. He told his disciples that he was going to die and that he was going to die on the cross and he was going to take all the punishment for all the bad stuff that the disciples or any of us ever did. Can you imagine? So Jesus was having the Last Supper with them where he broke bread and he ate with them. Now, some of the disciples were really confused. They're like, but Jesus, why are you going to do that? Why do you have to die for us? But Jesus reassured them that this plan was to save us all forever. Let's go to the next one. It is a heart. Yes, it is. It's a heart. How many of you guys know that God loves you so much? That's what Easter is really all about. He loves all of you who are feeling broken and lonely and disappointed. He died on the cross for all of the bad stuff that we've ever done. Our lives seem like a big mess sometimes. We mess up big time. All of us mess up. But you know what's really cool? Jesus died on the cross. Because he loved you. And that's what's going to happen this week on Good Friday. We pause and we think about how Jesus died on the cross for us. But guys and girls, you know what's really cool? Jesus died so that we can have life and we can have it forever. Jesus is with us. He'll never ever leave us. He's always going to be there with us. And even though our lives seem like they're messed up, Jesus died so our lives would be whole and their hearts would be put back together again. All the disappointment, all the shame, all the sickness, all the sorrow. And I want you to know that Jesus died on the cross. This cross is made out of nails. He died on the cross for you and for me because he loved us so much. You know what? Easter, it's fun having Easter egg hunts. I love having Easter egg hunts, and I love those little marshmallow peep eggs. You guys like those? But remember that this week when we begin to celebrate Easter, that Easter is all about God's love and how much Jesus loves you. That he died just because you are special to him. And he loves you more than you could ever possibly imagine. He really, really loves you. And he thinks that you are awesome. So remember that Easter is all about God's great love. Are you guys ready? Drum roll, everybody. Drum roll. We are going to be at Piano College. 9 o'clock or 11:30. We will be offering kids ministry, kids services at Piano College for your whole family. Make sure you register. Okay, are you ready for this?
Yes.
We are going to let all of you guys choose a Bible buddy with a memory booklet that you get to bring home on Easter Sunday. Also, you guys are all going to do some special Easter crafts, and we have a special Easter treat bag for you all to take home next week. And one more thing, if you wear a wacky, wild, crazy hat, you can get a special prize. So are you guys gonna wear your wacky crazy hats for Easter Sunday?
Yeah.
So remember, wear your hats. We'll see you next week at Keanu College. All right, Elias, are you ready to close in prayer? Let's count it down and look at the camera and here we go. Are you ready? 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you, God, that it's Palm Sunday. And thank you, God, that it's almost Easter, and help us have a great week. Amen.
Amen. All right. So it's time to say goodbye. But we can't wait. Next week, we were looking so forward to seeing you. Don't forget to register. Bye, everybody.
Bye. Woo-hoo!